children, I am so excited to be here with you today. Are you happy? Are you excited? Yes, I am so happy. So, I would like you to do one teeny-weeny thing for me. You go and call your friends. You go and call your brother. You go call your sisters. If you have your cousins around or your neighbors, you can call everybody and let's come together and start a lesson together. My name is Teacher Deborah. What is your name? Come on, tell your friend your name. Good. Now let's stand to each other and sing hello as we greet one another. Are we ready? Hello, 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 hello. It's nice for me to have you here. It's nice for me to have good job. Thank you for singing with me. It's time now for us to pray, and I would like us to put our hands together and then close our eyes. Hands together and eyes closed. Let us pray. Will you repeat after me? Come on, say, dear God, thank you for all the children. Thank you for all the people in the world. Lead us to learn today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Come on. Amen. 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 Yes. Thank you for praying with me. And we are going to have a special Bible moment. Do you have a Bible like me? Oh, yes, there should be a Bible somewhere there in your home. Okay, okay. This is my Bible. Come on, show me your Bible. This is my Bible. So we're going to take our little hands and part our Bibles. Are we ready to do that? Are we ready to do that? Okay, let's do this together. Take your little hand and pat, pat, pat. Take your little hand and pat, pat, pat. Take your little hand and pat, pat, pat. Pat the Holy Bible. Yes, yes, this is the Holy Bible. Do you know why it's called the Holy Bible? It is because it is God's special word for me and for you. It is God's special word for me and for you. And the Bible is a holy book of God. So, take good care of the Bible because it has a wonderful message for you and for me. Okay, now we're going to sing a song about the Bible. Are you excited? I would like you to listen to me sing, and then you will also sing with me the second time. Are we ready? Are we ready? Can we say B? B. Letter B. B. Say I. B. L E B I B L E. Yes, and that reads Bible. Can we say together Bible? Bible. Yes, the song we're going to sing is about the Bible. And it goes like this. The B-I-B-L-E. Yes, that's the book for me. I stand alone on the word of God. The B-I-B-L-E. get it? Okay, let's do it just one more time, and then we will go on to the next thing. Okay, are we ready? Can you say, yes, I am? Are you ready? Oh, let's sing together. Ready, steady, go. The B-I-B-L-E, yes, that's the word for me. I stand alone on the word of God, the B-I-B-L-E. Again, the B-I-B-L-E, yes, that's the word for me. I stand alone on the word of God, the B-I-B-L-E. Yes, the Bible is the word of God, and it is very, very special. So, no writing in the Bible, okay? No pulling pages out of the Bible. Take good care of the Bible because it's a special word of God. And ask mommy, ask daddy, ask jaja, granny, grandma or grandpa, ask uncle or auntie to read the Bible for you, because the Bible is the holy word of God and it helps us to grow. So children, today I have a very special story for you. You see, I have a special story about a very special baby. No, not your baby brother. Mm-mm. Yes, your baby brother is a very special baby. I am talking about a special, cherished baby who was sent by God. And that baby is called Baby Jesus. Are we ready to listen to the story? Come on, if you're ready to listen to the story, can you touch your ears? Touch your ears. Let me see you touch your ears. Yes, like that. Uh-huh. Are you listening? Are you sitting down? Good children, good boys and girls. That's very good. So, the story is about baby Jesus. And it is from a special holy word of God, the Bible. And that story is from the book of Luke, chapter 2, from verse 1 to 7. And here is the story, children. In those days, a powerful ruler called Augustus Caesar commanded all the people who were under his leadership to go and be counted. He said, I want everybody, every man, every woman, every child, everybody, I want them to go and be counted and be registered in their hometown. So there was a man called Joseph and a woman called Mary. Mary was promised to marry Joseph. She was going to become the wife of Joseph, and Joseph would become her husband. But Mary had a baby in her belly, and her belly was so big. So they had to travel a very long, long journey and travel to a town called Bethlehem of Judea. So they traveled and traveled. They walked every day, walking, and they got so exhausted, but they finally got there. And when they reached in the town of Bethlehem, where they were supposed to be counted, where they're supposed to be registered, Mary had a baby. Yes, Mary had a very, very special baby. The baby was called Baby Jesus. She had a baby, but she did not have where to stay. Yes, there was no hospital for her to stay. There was no guest room for her to stay. There was no house. So Joseph and Mary went into a stable, and Jesus was born in a manger. Can you say manger? Manger. Yes, Jesus was born in a manger. So Mary took her baby Jesus and wrapped him up in clothes and put him in a manger. Do you see my manger here? I have a manger, I have some dry straw, and I have some cloth and a little baby in here. Can we all say manger? This right here in front of me looks like a manger. It is my manger today. And I have some dry straw in the manger, like the one that Mary and Joseph had for a little bed for their baby. So Jesus was wrapped in clothes so that he could be warm and cuddly like this little baby doll I have here. And he was put in a manger. Do you know why he was put in a manger? Who remembers? Because his mommy and his daddy did not have any room to stay in. They did not have a house and they did not have a guest room because all the places were full. So that is how the most cherished, the most wonderful little baby Jesus was born. Do you love that story? Do you love Jesus? Now, baby Jesus was born so that you and me can be saved. Baby Jesus was born to love you and me. Okay? So I would like you to stand up. Come on, stand up. Stand up on your feet, everybody. Stand up. Are you standing up? Good. Now we're going to sing to baby Jesus. I want you to pretend to be Mary and you have a baby. Come on, get a baby. Get something. Get a baby and wrap them up. Like me, I am wrapped a baby up and I'm holding a baby. I'm going to pretend that this is baby Jesus and we're going to sing together for baby Jesus. Are you ready? Are you ready? I know you know this song. Okay, let's sing together. Baby Jesus, baby Jesus, I love you. Your baby down gently, quietly, carefully. So, boys and girls, baby Jesus was sent by God to save me and you and you and you and you and you. Who was baby Jesus sent to save? He was sent to save me. And you, and you, and you, and you, and you. Baby Jesus was sent to save everybody. And guess what? Baby Jesus loves all of us. Who does baby Jesus love? Baby Jesus loves me, and you, and you, and you, and you, and you. So baby Jesus loves all of us. He loves all of us. He came to save all of us, and that is why he is a very, very special and cherished baby. All right, so it is time for us to pray as we end our lesson today. So I would like us to remember these things about baby Jesus. We should remember, always remember, that baby Jesus loves you and he loves me. Come on, can you give me a hug? Yes. Jesus loves us all. He loves you and he loves me. Let's also remember that Jesus was a special baby. And so are you. All the little boys, all the little girls, you are all very, very special babies. So it is time for us to pray as we wind up our lesson today. We're going to stand up and we will sing a song together. Who remembers our prayer song? You remember our prayer song? Yes. Let's humble ourselves as we sing together. God is listening. God is listening when we pray, when we pray. Put our hands together, close our eyes so quietly, then we will pray. Thank you, God, for the special gift of baby Jesus. Teach me to love him and to listen to him. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Come on, amen. Say with me, amen. 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 Good job. Thank you for praying with me. And now it's time for us to say goodbye. Can you stand up and say goodbye to me? Come on. And let's sing it. Let's sing the goodbye, okay? Goodbye. 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 Till we meet again another day. Till we meet again another day. Bye, children.
Thank you so much, Teacher Deborah. I welcome you once again to our online Sunday service. I'm Teacher Jerome, and I hope you've had a wonderful and fabulous week. We are still continuing with our wonderful theme of obedience. So I hope you're now ready to learn more. You're ready to get to know more about obedience. Before I go any further, before I do anything else, let us pray. Hands together, eyes closed. Father, I thank you for this wonderful and beautiful morning. We thank you for all that you have done for us. We pray that you may be with us as we enjoy your presence. In Jesus' name I've prayed. Amen. Wow. Now, I hope you're ready to dance. I hope you're ready to shake, to praise the Lord. So prepare yourselves. Tell your brother, hey, 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 come. It's time for praise and worship. Let us join the OLIVES choir for praise and worship.
Hello, children. Welcome to our online service. Please humble yourself for a word of prayer. Lord, we thank you for today. We thank you for the gift of life. We ask that you'll receive our praise. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen.
Amen.
Anything, if I run over here, if I run over here.
Thank you, Olives Choir, for that wonderful and awesome time. I hope you enjoy the praise and worship. Were you able to dance for the Lord? Are you able to praise Him? That's great. Now it's time for us to get warmed up, to keep warm. So we are going to dance to a song, and I want you to follow along. Are you ready? Hope you have enjoyed our energizer. Woo. I am all warmed up. Now grab your pen, pencil, and notebook. Prepare your heart as we head over to Teacher Davis for our lesson. Again, and welcome to our second lesson this month. As usual, my name is Teacher Davis, and I'm always excited to have you joining us. Now, I hope you still remember where we left off last week when we shared about our theme, obedience. Do you remember? I know you do, because I also remember where I left off last week. Now, before we get too busy and too engaged talking about our good story in the Bible, how about we open up with a word of prayer? Would you like that? I bet you would. So, hands together and eyes closed. Heavenly Father, we thank you for always providing us with energy and everything that we need to keep alive and healthy. We pray that you will guide us and give us the wisdom we need for this lesson. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Now, where did we leave our lesson last week? We talked about obedience. What else did we talk about? That passage in the Bible, which scripture was that? Let's see if any of you remembers. Which scripture was that? Yes, Genesis. Genesis chapter 6. From verse 11 to 22. Right. And we talked about a man. There was this guy we talked about. What was the name of this man? Who knows? Yes, the name was Noah. Yes, we say Noah had three sons. Who remembers? I mentioned that last week. Now, if you are attentive enough, you would be remembering where we left off. So, the names of the three sons were Ham, Seth, and lastly, Japheth. Yes, Noah had three sons, Ham, Seth, and Japheth. Perfect. Now, what happened in that story? The earth was full of sin. God had a plan. What was God's plan? Yes, to destroy everyone on earth and everything on earth except for Noah and his family.
So God's plan was Noah was supposed to build a big boat, which we called an ark. 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 A-R-K. Ark. A boat, but it is bigger. So Noah was told to add every kind of living creature, whether birds, animals in the wild, crawling creatures like snakes and lizards. But he was told to bring two of every kind, a male and a female. And by the time we left off, we had read verse 22, which said that Noah did everything that God told him to do. And that's when we defined obedience. We said obedience is, who remembers? Doing everything you are told to do. Perfect. Let's repeat that one more time for those that are joining us for their very first time, who are very welcome, by the way, and those that might have forgotten. We said obedience is doing everything you are told to do. It's not just about listening or saying yes, it is actually doing it, right? And then we shared one last detail. Who remembers? We shared our memory verse, and I want us to review it before we go any further. We shared from Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 1. So let's go over to our memory verse board and see if we recall the words there. We recited Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 1. One more time. Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 1. What does it say? It says, if you fully obey the Lord and carefully follow all his commands I give you today, the Lord your God will set you high above all the nations on earth. Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 1. Let's say that one more time. You can read if you forgot the words. It's fine. Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 1. What does it say? If you fully obey the Lord and carefully follow all his commands I give you today, the Lord your God will set you high above the nations on earth. Let's recite that with our eyes closed, without looking at the board. Close your eyes. I can see you're peeping. You stop peeping. Just close your eyes. Let's see if you remember. What does it say? Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 1. What does it say? If you fully obey the Lord and carefully follow all his commands I give you today, the Lord your God will set you high above all the nations on earth. Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 1. Wow, you guys did great. That was our memory verse. Now, today, we are going to continue where we stopped. Are you excited about the story? We are going to continue where Noah said, yes, he would build the ark, and see what happened after that. So let's go over to the tell table and listen to our story today. Let me meet you at the tell table. Welcome to the tell table, where we share in the stories of the big book, the Bible. So, as we usually do, we come over and share in a passage of scripture. Last time when we left off, we had looked at chapter 6 of Genesis. We talked about Noah and how Noah said yes to building an ark. And Noah began to build. So today we are going to build on that story and see what happened after Noah began building the ark. So let's go over to the Bible in Genesis. Get your Bible and open Genesis. That is the first book of the Bible. case you forgot. So Genesis chapter 7. We are going to read from Genesis chapter 7. And we shall see what happened after Noah said yes to building the ark. The Bible says that by that time, Noah was 600 years old. Now, that's really, really old. Like, it's not 6 years old like some of you are. Not 16 like some of your elder siblings are. It's not 60 years like Jaja. It's 600 years old. Wow. That's really old. Like Noah was really old. And yet he had three sons. You remember the names of the sons? Ham, Sesan, Japheth. Now, when you think about it, this guy might have been even so weak to build the ark. But he said, it's okay because God has told me to build an ark. I will build it. What do we learn from that? Even if it's uncomfortable or not very cool for you to obey, maybe your parent tells you to do something and your friends say, nah, that's not cool. You still do that? You still wash the dishes at your age? Well, like Noah, it was a bit uncool for a 600-year-old man to build an ark as big as this. Yet he said, yes, I will obey the Lord. So the Lord told Noah, when Noah finished building his ark, the big ark, and putting all the animals he was supposed to put in there, the Lord told him, in 7 days, it is going to begin to rain, and the floods will kill every living creature on the earth. Okay, Noah said, okay, my Lord. So Noah packed enough food for him and his family in the ark. I think they carried a big sack of, I don't know, beans and posho. What do you eat? What do you like eating? Macaroni? What else? I think they carried food, both food like vegetables, fruits, and I think they even had some animals on there, chicken to fry and roast, and fire, a fireplace on the ark. So Noah prepared in those 7 days, and people would find Noah building the ark and tell him, Noah, what are you doing? Noah is like, God told me in 7 days it is going to rain and the floods will come and kill everyone unless they enter the ark. And people looked at him like, Noah, you can't be serious. Like, it's taken many, many months without raining here. How do you think it is going to rain? More so, flood, and we die. Noah, you're just old. You are 600 years old. You are very old. You don't think properly. Noah laughed at them, and they also laughed at him because they thought what Noah was doing was not cool. Well, guess what? After 7 days, it began raining. It began as a drizzle. Tukutu, tukutu, tukutu. On the iron sheets and the roofs of the people. Everyone thought, nah, it is just rain. It's not what Noah said. We shall not die. Why much shall we die? No, we shall not die. So everyone was comfortable saying, this is no more rain. It began drizzling and raining, and more as the days went by, it became heavy and heavier. It rained and rained and rained and rained until the waters started flooding. The oceans became so full, the rivers became so full, and the lakes became so full that the waters began spilling over to the people's houses, and the floods began to rise. Now people realize, danger has come our way. We need to run! But guess what? The Lord had sealed the ark already, and Noah and his family were safe. Now these people who were outside, they said, Noah was right. It would rain. Now it is raining. We are about to die. The floods came, like you see my waters here. The floods came and came and came, and then the waters began coming up. People started to swim. I can't swim. I will not die. These floods are not going to kill me. They began to swim, but they realized, as they tried to swim, and they could not breathe properly. They began to swim. The animals began to swim. The houses became submerged in the water. Everyone was covered in the water, and no one could breathe. And what Manoa had told everyone had come to Pastor Vlad's, who were killing them. Everyone was trying, but no one survived. Some people thought, if I climb a tall tree, maybe then I will not die. So they tried to climb tall trees very up. And they climbed. And then they were like, here the floods will not get me. As they were still up, the floods came climbing up, until they covered even the tallest of trees. The Bible says even the highest of mountains was covered. People died, and their animals were destroyed, and their property was all covered. Meanwhile, Noah was in the ark, sailing like the boss, having his good time because he obeyed. The other people who didn't obey, what happened to them? Yeah, it's a sad story. They died. But what happened to Noah who obeyed, who actually obeyed? He was in the boat, in this ark, with his family, sailing. Ooh, feels good, right? Yeah. It feels good when you obey. So if you don't learn anything from my story, at least you've learned this one thing, that when we obey, good things happen. And when we disobey, bad things happen. Would you like to be one of the other people who didn't obey and were left in the flood and died? Or would you like to be like Noah and his family, who obeyed the word of God, built the ark God told them to build, and when the floods came, for them they were sailing. Good things happened to them because they obeyed. Now, I want to tell you that after 150 days, the floods were on the earth. People had died. 150 days, the floods began to calm down. The rain stopped. The sun came out, and the floods began to go down, until Noah and his ark landed and settled on a mountain called Mountain Ararat. Noah and his family in the ark and all the animals God told him to put there landed, and they were safe when the floods were down. When the floods came down, Noah came out as the survivor, the superstar of this movie, and he and his family lived a happy life ever after. You like the story? Yes, you did. I also enjoyed it. Now, I want us to remember these 2 points from our lesson today as we bring it to a close. From the story we have shared in Genesis chapter 7, the Bible teaches us that when we obey, like Noah when he said, "Yes, I will do what the Lord commands me to do," when we obey, good things happen to us. When we disobey, bad things happen to us. Let me say that one more time. When we obey, good things happen to us. When we disobey, bad things happen to us. Let us remember that even as we go through this week, that you need to learn to obey. Obey your parents, obey your teachers and your elders at church, even at home. When they tell you to do something, do it, because when you do, good things will happen, and when you don't, bad things will definitely happen. Let's review our memory verse one more time and we shall be good to go. Where is our memory verse coming from? Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 1. What does it say? If you fully obey the Lord and carefully follow all his commands I give you today, the Lord your God will set you high above all the nations on the earth. Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 1. Let us pray. Hands together and eyes closed. Father, we thank you because we have learned that when we obey, good things will happen to us. And when we disobey, bad things will happen. We pray that you will help us to obey so that good things will happen in our lives. And teach us not to disobey you, or the elders, nor the teachers, nor the parents that you have given us. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Bye, children. Let me see you next week. Here again. goodbye.
Thank you so much, Teacher Davies, for that wonderful lesson. I've really learned and enjoyed the lesson. And it's time for us to go through our memory verse. I hope you remember where it comes from. It's from Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 1. And if you fully obey the Lord your God and carefully follow all his commands I give you today, the Lord will set you high above all nations. We are going to say it with actions. Do you still remember our actions? Do you still remember? Okay, we are going to do it with actions. Are you ready? If you're ready, put up your hand. Okay, so now let us start. Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 1. If you fully obey the Lord your God and carefully follow all his commands I give you today, the Lord will set you high above all nations. Let us do it again. Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 1. If you fully obey the Lord your God and you carefully follow all his commands I give you today, the Lord will set you high above all nations. Let us do that one more time. Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 1. If you fully obey the Lord your God and carefully follow all his commands I give you today, the Lord will set you high above all nations. You want us to do it one more time? Okay, let us do it one more time. Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 1. And if you fully obey the Lord your God and carefully follow all his commands I give you today, the Lord will set you high above all nations. Wow! So please take time to memorize it even better and better and better. As we come to the end of our service, please don't forget to hit the notification bell and to subscribe to our channel. If you've liked our service, give us a thumbs up. That's all I had for you today. Till next Sunday. Bye.